think about this and try to follow, and then we will again हम लोग कुछ आगे की बात कहें. We will tell, explain. Yes, but these are very important to follow all this. If you are not following, that internally you are not following bhakti, you don't want bhakti, you want only sense gratification or only to avoid suffering. That is it. Gaur very important. So if we cannot explain whole, but we can take some essence. Kirtan.
Hare Krishna.
Dharma, 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 Dhar
When will you attain?
I did not fully understand.
What?
You were telling that the process for becoming true Vairagya is thinking everything is for Krishna? I don't know. What is the process? How to do this?
A bhakti is coming. A little shraddha is there. Pure transcendental shraddha will come. And following, serving Krishna and Guru, automatically Vairagya will come.
But how not
then
becoming
he
false
will
Vairagya?
Then he will think that everything in this whole world for the enjoyment of Krishna. So we should take it and offer him. And to maintain our life, we can take anything prasadam. Like a prasadam, but very little.
But how do we keep away false Vairagya?
Then false Vairagya automatically glowing. If you are chanting, remembering Krishna, and from internally you want bhakti, then it will come. And real bhakti, Vairagya will come. Transcendental Vairagya. Like Sukhdev Goswami, like Narad Goswami, like all.
Gaur Pranande.
Chant and remember.
Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe. Radhe 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 Jai 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 Shri Radhe.
Knowing or unknowing, you are doing something. If you are speaking, also doing something. Taking air and in breathing, lakhs and lakhs instead of it. If you are walking, whether you are breathing or not, lakhs and lakhs insects and so many things. You are taking water in that in water also. And if you are doing knowingly, then nothing to come. What is think of that? So we are doing some wrong things, and that is called sin. So in India, in Vedic knowledge, Vedic culture, it has been told that all should do five pancha suna yajna. If you are taking anything, first give it to fire. Some cows, some needy persons, and then death. So you should try to do all these things. Otherwise you will have to test the fruits of this bad karma. But if you are telling lie, cheating others, not serving your father and mother who have given birth, you are not doing for earth on which you are living and doing so much nonsense, digging, giving stone and passing during to this, giving so much. So sometimes for maintaining us, we kill so many animals. In America and our best country, also in India, it is heavy to have fishing. They don't think that it is an issue. As if Krishna, God has created them for us, that we will finish fishing and for hen, oh, cutting, for goats, now the cows. So in a sky there is nothing which cannot be taken. Only one thing. Kite. aeroplanes and people, or otherwise they will fail. And in this, on earth what? Train, chairs will not be there. But take bicycle. How?
And many people used to come and worship him. And he used to after some time, appreciate the worship. And he thought that he would do more austerities and become even a greater brahmacharya. So he submerged himself in icy water. He submerged himself in icy water. Yeah?
Where it is written in Bhagavatam, where?
My godbrother told me from what Purana he has. He has on Bhagavatam.
First you should tell what is written there, and then after that, why her Brahmin?
So Ajamil, as a young boy,
Ajamil,
as Ajamil,
no, Ajamil,
Ajamil, as a young boy, he was also very Pakka Brahmachari. He knew all Vedic scriptures. He was very well behaved. He was celibate. He knew how to respect guests and elderly people. And his father always engaged him in deity worship and brahminical activities. And one day, as he was going out getting paraphernalia for deity worship,
married,
he saw...
Oh,
he
was also married?
Yeah.
Yeah. Not only married.
In his young age.
He was married. He was not in house, unmarried, but he was married with a very chaste and qualified girl. And he had also some children.
So when he was married and he had some children, he had a very chaste wife. he went out to serve his Gurudev and he saw a... Service of Gurudev.
No.
Father.
Yeah.
Service of father. For the father's sacrifice.
So try to read yourself this literature. Then we are there to speak.
Some small points are like that. So then we get to the stage where he finally meets the prostitute. Shamelessly embracing the Paya Sutra.
How he met?
When he went to the forest to get the firewood for his father's fire. And the woman, she had turmeric on her body also, which agitates the mind even more. It's one of the tricks a woman has of agitating the mind. So he also became very agitated, it says in the Bhagavatam. We see in India that many women, they smear turmeric in their bodies. So like that, his mind got agitated and he forgot all the things, all the good instructions that he'd learned from his father and from small boy. He forgot everything and he fell down with that prostitute. And he led a life of very sinful activities. He would steal from people and he would do all nonsense. He would gamble anyway to get money by hook or crook, to maintain the family, because after some time he had many children to this prostitute.
He stole away all the wealth from his father, mother, and he gave it to
prostitute.
How he captured? She captured. How she captured him? First, when he could not take control of his senses, especially lust. Then it took so many gold and everything. And one to give and to control that lady. But she took everything and he used to leave him so much wine. Wine. So much wine. And taking wine of all intelligence and everything. And so much lust came that he gave us himself in the, to the that but
Ajamil, before fall down, he tried to remember that Brahman, he tried to get salvation from this.
So it had been told that you should not see a naked
get salvation.
And you cannot take and control at that time. No? So better not to go. Don't take wine. Follow four basic principles. Then go.
So because he saw this woman, he lost all his intelligence, and he fell down with her and engaged in all sinful activities, and he had...
And she used to chastise him. Bring more, bring more. And because he was so much thirsty, he was controlled by that. Then he had no money, then he used to go to store. Steal money by dacoity, by cutting others, by robbing, anyhow, by pulling them. Go on.
Actually, one time Srila Prabhupada heard on a tape that if a man and woman they're married, and if someone comes to steal their money, the man will have them arrested by the police. But if a woman comes to take all the money, the man will think, oh, I have a very good wife. So, Prabhupada told that a man and woman are married. If the wife comes and takes money from the pocket, the man will think, oh, I have a nice wife. But if someone comes to rob money, they will call the police. But the wife is doing the same job. Prompted him to call the last child, the seventh or eighth child, Narayan. So the time of his death came to Arjamil, and because he was so attached to this small boy, Narayan, whenever he took food, he called the child to take food, and whenever he took water, he called that boy to come and take water, and he was always calling him Narayan. So throughout his life, the Bhagavatam says that he'd already chanted Namabhas, by chanting his son. And it says that there's different kinds of namabhas, one who says jokingly to indicate something else, or in a musical way, then it forms namabhas. And by namabhas, all of one's sinful activity, it says for millions of lifetimes, were already atoned for. So at the time of death, he yelled out Narayan, because that was in his heart. And three Yamadutas came because he committed sinful activity with his mind, with his speech, and with his body. So when they came there, immediately the Vishnu Dutas came because they called the name of his master.
Immediately came on, they began to take his soul.
Bite his soul up.
And he was crying like and weeping. At that time, then Narayan spoke.
While they were binding him, he was very fearful and crying in a distress.
And so, at that time he called.
Then he saw his child.
At that time. So when the Vishnu Dutas came, the Yama Dutas, they saw these four effulgent personalities, and they were shocked at why they're coming there to a place where this sinful Arjamil was. And so they started to have a conversation of what is religious principles. And if you know what is religious principles, why have you come here? Because he's under the jurisdiction of Yamaraj. He's not under the jurisdictions of Vishnu or Narayan. So then a dialogue took place. And they told him that because he called the son of Narayan our master, then he's come under our jurisdictions, you cannot touch him. So within the minds of the Yamadutas, they were starting to think that I thought that Yamaraj was in charge of justice. Now I'm hearing that someone else is higher than him. So then after that they had a conversation, what is religious principles? And then they...
What was the discussion between them?
The discussion was that the Vishnu Dudas and the Yamadudas, they asked, they came to the conclusion, but who was under the... The Vishnu Dudas told, who was under the influence of Yamaraj? And they said, one who has never once chanted the holy name of the Lord, or who has never visited a holy place, who is engaged in sinful activity. One who is engaged in sinful activity and who has not followed religious principles or engaged in any of the regulated principles mentioned in the scriptures, he comes under the jurisdiction of Yamaraj. And one who even in some way follows the path of religious principles, he doesn't come under the influence of Yamaraj, the superintendent of death.
What
after that? So after that, just when they told what is that they established that Narayan is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and that Yamaraj is under his.
Can you tell him?
Hare Krishna.
What
did he ask? Ajamil get salvation. His life was a very simple life, but he gets salvation only because he never make a Vaishnava aparata. It's only for this, Bhagavan.
I'm telling what was the dialogue between them. Where is Prem Prayajan? Can you tell?
So here, Vishnu Dutas, they came, the Yama Dutas, the messengers of the Lord of Death, Yamaraj.
Lord, Lord, we pray, Lord.
They came and they were very ferocious, with their teeth sticking out and their hair standing on end, and very black and ugly and deformed. And three of them came.
How many nails?
Nails. And they came with ropes, and they bound the throat of Ajamil and began to drag him out from his body. So at that time, Ajamil was so terrified, and he called out in great horror, Narayan, who is mindfully absorbed in the name of Narayan, though he was calling his son. So at that time, four Vishnu Dutas, the messengers of Lord Vishnu, they appeared there, most brilliantly effulgent, and with gold crowns and this club conch, lotus flower, they appeared there and began to threaten the Yamadutas, but let him go, can't punish him. The Yamadutas were so astonished to see someone obstructing their activities, because this is what they do.
Do you know what is dharma or what is adharma? What is right and what is wrong, you know? Then the guest, we know.
So
can you tell? Then they began to tell.
Yes.
But Jamaduta began to tell.
So the Yamadutas, they said to the Vishnu Dutas, how do you have the audacity to stop us from taking this very sinful person? Because in this world, everyone is performing, knowingly or unknowingly, sinful activities. So we shall take him. But then the Vishnu Dutta said...
What sin has he done?
The Vishnu Dutta said to the
Yama...
Can anyone? Prabhu? Purushottam?
Yes.
Are you asking me here? You? You have read thoroughly? To me?
And then the third one, you will come around.
No, listen. I know that you cannot do. Vishnu, to that moment. What are you doing? Nonsense? Do you know what is religious religion or in religion? Dharma? Dharma or dharma? Or yes? He was a very good Brahman son. Always doing right things. He learned Vedas, all the Vedic culture. And when he became young, he was married to a religious lady. But being in bad situation, he had left his chaste wife and children. He had left for all good activities, fire sacrifice, serving father, mother, everything. And after that he began to take wine, to cut animals and all other human beings. He had murdered less and less persons also. And he had taken and he had looted all money from. In this world, there is no sin that he has not done. All kinds of sins. He has not even repented for this. He has not done prayaschit.
Atonement
also. Nothing. So, we are ordered from Jamdev to take all the persons like these souls, bad souls, and to bring to Jamalaya. And to get so much pain for their bad activities. So we are right and we have come to get peace. Then Vishnu Dutta told, I think that you don't know anything. All the beings of this world are sleeping, getting their heads on the lap of Jamdev, that he will do right, he will never do wrong. And you have been sent by him. I think that you have not been sent by him, but you are doing wrong without his order. You know that at the time of death, willingly or unwillingly, he has chanted the name of Narayan. So he, all kinds of bad activities, sins, even he has murdered hundreds and thousands. He has looted. He has taken wine. He has left his father, mother, and served a prostitute. And for this he has opened a jivan bekar. But even he has told one time, when he uttered this name and he kept this name to his boy, first time all his sins have been gone. And now what he is telling, oh Narayan, bring water, bring this, that. Oh, kissing him, Narayan is very good boy. These are repetitions of them, that is, this is practice of bhakti. Why he is doing so nonsense after keeping his name Narayan and he again began to murder and doing all these sins? Oh, after taking this name, what he is doing, activity, like, they are like burnt rope. If any rope is there and it is burnt in fire, even the crookedness of a rope is seen there, but it will not act anything. Anything cannot be minded by that rope which has been burned. So his all activities are burned without any result. Who can see it? Who are realized? They can see this, but general people cannot. Oh, they will see that he is doing, going on. That is why in Gita it has been told, apichesu dugacharo vajate imam nandibhav sadhu reva samantap sambat bhavastohisa. If anyone doing apichesu dugacharo, doing so much nonsense things, but ananya, taking name of Krishna, ananya bhavena,
means with single-minded
devotion, then you should think that he is really a sadhu. Even he is doing going on. Because his all sins and everything has been burned, you should see him like a sadhu. Because after some days, chipram bhavati dharmatma swastha chanti nigacchati pati janahi kaunteya. My bhakti cannot be. So we should know like this. If a devotee chanting, remembering, but by weakness he has come to a family life, we should not criticize them. But don't have association from of that kind of heart. Never. Like we, like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But don't criticize. Chipram bhavati dharmatma. He will surely, if he has not offended any nam aparad, he has not insulted Vaishnava's guru and other, very soon he will quickly again come. Very quickly. What is the meaning of quickly? If in this unlimited time, if we are taking hundreds of birth, it is very tricky, very tricky. Because there is no end of this life taking birth. If in 100 births we are being no heart, but he will chipram in our next life, like Bharat, maybe. So don't criticize. But if anyone is so innocent, following the Vedas, and doing so much good things, never speaks lie, and he serves father, mother, and he is doing accordingly all the Vedic culture he is following, but not chanting name, we should not associate, and that you should not think him sadhu. Never. So here he is telling that Vishnu Dutas, that fan he took first, and he gave the name of Narayan. At once, his all sins have been burned. No absence.
Before and after,
and for future. All. But if he will think that by uttering the name of Narayan or Vishnu, if my all sins will go away and has gone away, so I can make some more sin, and again I will take them, and again
it will go away.
Then it will be Namapara. Then Krishna will not fall. Name cannot fall.
This is without knowing that glory of name, you are chanting the name. So name was.
Yes. Then it will be Namapara. So you should try to know these things very. He has no Namapara. Nothing. He was simply doing all these things. He had not known the power of name, power of Vishnu Bhakta, devotees, or Krishna. No, he had not criticized
offended any Vaishnava or Krishna name or any of the 10 Namaparad. So, he is telling that even he had done so many wrongs, he had chanted name Narayan. He had chanted the same Narayan in his last life, last breath, when they were taking and bending and taking him to Yamaraj. And he told Narayan. So, Vishnu Dutara is telling, all kinds of sarvesham api abhavatam idam eva sunishkritam nam vyaharan Vishnu jat tad vishayati. That was only by taking the name at that time, all kinds of sin, murders and so many things, going to prostitutes, disobeying his father, mother and wife, not supporting his children, all the things. So, he has done everything, he has completed everything in his life, nothing to do any atonement for
him. He has done his atonement completely.
But only this you should remind. Like Jagai Mathai Bole, Aar Nare Baap. Aar Nare Baap. When Jagai Mathai came in the Saranagatua, took shelter in the lotus of Nityananda Prabhu and Mahaprabhu, then Mahaprabhu ordered them, Arna Karishpa, don't do any evil things, all kinds of sins. And they took their hands on their ears. And they, and Unnani Kasam Khai, that in our life we will never do like this. Never, never, never. Three times. And at once, strictly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave prayer in their hearts. And they began to make, oh Krishna, oh Krishna. Surfacing like hearts, they began to groan and began to do so many prayers. Hearts so clear and honoring all people at once. So Vishnu Dutar came in that he has done everything. Not is not Baba. But Vishnu Jamaduta were in doubt that he took name and after that he again did. Again did. Vishnu Dutar are telling by name, past, Vartaman, present and future, all kinds of sin will go away. So don't think about it. But they are not satisfied. Who are you? We are Vishnu Dut. We have no power to interfere in this. And saying this to begin again, find the soul of man. Then Vishnu Dut took their horses, defeated them, and thus they ran away. And went to jump and go. Then they defeated them, and they at once ran away to Jam Maharaj and complained against them. Up till now you have known that you are the sole creator and what?
Supreme
Personality of Godhead.
Supreme
control. But we see that you are not like so. Someone came and they interfered in our this class, your service. Then what became? He told, oh, they told the Holy Spirit. Then he told, namaskar. To whom?
Narayan.
To Narayan, Supreme Personality. And he told, hmm?
under the, I'm under a supreme controller, and Narayan is supreme controller. Jab Maharaj has no connection with link with Krishna, supreme personality in present. Like constables, they can be in control of Havaldar, Colonel, and SP only. They have nothing to do with IG and President, and they are not interested because they are very small, in small position. Chowkidar in village, very low position. They have nothing to do with IG. So, Jamaraj is always in connection with Narayan. So, he is telling that my controller, my Vasakadu is Narayan. And only wish some we know all the deepest thoughts of religion. Who? Swayambhu, Narada, Shambhu, Kumara, Kapilo, Manu, Prahlado, Janako, Vishnu, Bali, Vaiyasaki, Vayam. Dvaras ete vijanimo dharma bhagavatam vada guhyam visuddham durbodhante jnan aritam pasute etani var lokesmin kunsa dharma parasmita bhakti yogo bhagavati tanna. There are 12 persons. They are Mahajan. When he was telling at what time? In Shaktaju. But now more prominent Mahajan are here. Who are they? More important. More. So he is telling the of our Shaktaju. Swayambhu, Brahma, Nara, Mahadev, Shankar, four Kumars, Kapi, Manu, who has written Manu Smriti, Prahlad, Jana, Bhishma, Bali Maharaj, he left his Gurudev, who was against Krishna service. Vyasaki, Vyasaki Manam, Sukadeva Goswami, and Vayam, who am? Myself,
Jammara.
We know the deepest meaning of other not. So, in this world, etan eva lokesmin punsa para dharma, pura dharma, smita, bhakti yoga, bhagavati tannam brahmanandhi. So, in this world, for human being, for all living entity, only one dharma is generated. But to chant the name of and others, Adhidhidhya, Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu, Svarnam, Bhavishindam, Archanam, Vandanam, Rashtrachanam, all these things. Very powerful. So he has done everything you have. He has done everything. So you should not go to them. Jivan Bhakti Bhagavat Guna Namakheyam Chetaschana Smartacharnaravindam Krishnaya no namati jatsira ekada vitan anayattham asato akt vishnu. In this world, though they have served father, mother and did worldly very good activities, but Jivan Bhakti Bhagavat Guna Namakheyam, those who are not always uttering the name of Krishna. And who is not always meditating the pastimes of Krishna. And Jiva not uttering the name of Krishna. And the person whose head is not Krishna, not doing pranam to Krishna. Or deity, or to devotees, even devotees. Tan anur, you should go and bring all these. Those who are chanting name,
who are hearing Bhagavad Katha, those who are doing urgent to Bhagavan, don't go. Even they are chanting Namapara, you cannot go to them. Then they are
under control of
Vishnu, not under the whether he is doing Namavas or Namapara, even Krishna will control them. You are, I am not that. So you should not go to them. Those who have taken Kanti Mala, and they have been initiated, whether this initiation is wrong or right, no fault. Vishnu mantra has been given. Any chanting name, don't go. Don't go. If at the time of death they are touched with Tulsi leaves, Bhagavad Pothi, the book of Srimad Bhagavat, Gita, and any devotee he has come and giving Ganges water or Tulsi attached to his body anywhere, don't go there. Otherwise you will have to be punished. Then he did pranam and he died. But when he was saved from death and he heard all the dialects very patiently, oh, how wonderfully I am saved from this grave. He wanted to touch the lotus feet of four Vishnu. Wherefore Vishnu do? Na, Ra, Ya, Na. Four letters were four messengers of Vishnu. So he wanted to touch their feet. You have set me. But at once they listened. Then he took his life and he went to Haridwar, where Ganges comes in land from hills side. And there he took bath. And any place he began to chant the same name when what four messengers of Narayan has told, thinking them like that his bona fide guru. Om Narayanaya. Om Bhagavate Vasudevaya, like this, and he began to chant. His heart has been cleared by taking the darshan of these four messengers of Vishnu. And hearing the scene, this scene there, he has a very strong faith on name. If my name was not pure, even I have been saved by this, that if I will chant this pure name only to serve Narayan, then that will be very more benefit. Now he took his mind intentness. One ended. Nothing to remain of his life. One minute. Waiting. And after some days, when he received some praying, Adhu Satta Tata Sadhu Sangha, he galloped something. At once Nishtha came, and from Nishtha Ruchi, and Ruchi to Asakti, and then Vishnu Dut again came. Told that to go. Everything has been successful. We have come to take you to Vaikunth. And once, he gave up his body, this material body, transcendental body came. What was here? And they took it only. Airplane, transcendental airplane. And they took it at once. So we should have very strong faith in this God's name, Narayan and Krishna name or any Jagannath. But there are three kinds of names. First two kinds. the names of Krishna which are connected with this world, like Jagannath, Jagannya, Ishwar, Paramatma, all these names are second class. And Shuddhana, primary names, are divided into two. First, where there is opulence in these names, like Nishingha, Baman, Ram, like other names, Narayan, they are opulence. And those that have sweet names of brother, they are more powerful. If you are taking chanting name of Narayan, you can go to opulence with Vaikunth. And if you are chanting Sri Krishna Govinda Hare Mukunda Govinda Nanda Kishore Krishna
Shanta, Dasya, half of Shakta,
and half of Vatsalya also, and some Madhur, partly Madhur, Manushvaki. So, he is somewhat same Narayan as Ram, but there is some difference in Rasa. And Ram has this quality, but Krishna, all the 12 Rasa, he is object of 12 Rasa. Ram is especially is the deity of Karma Rasa. Karma Rasa. And he is God. So, 3 times more than Narayana or Ramana. So, in Krishna Nam also, there is some gradation. And what is in this? Sri Krishna. Sri Krishna Govinda. Govinda, this Naam has been given by Indra. Always grazing cows, supporting cows. So Govinda, Krishna the son of Yashoda Maiya. Govinda. Sri Krishna Govinda. Gopala Hare Mukunda. And then Govinda He Nanda Kishore Krishna Hasi Yashoda Tanay. There is son of Yashoda Devi. First Nanda Tanay. Yashoda Tanay is somewhat superior than Nanda Tanay. And from Nanda Tanay, Yashoda Tanay, Ballavi Jeevan means beloved of gopis. And after that, Sri Radhika is Oshodi. So Radhana, Radha Govinda, Radha Mama, this is Oshodi. It is Mandi. Radha Ramada Hari Govinda. Radha Hari Govinda.
Then his father
made a sacrifice. What he was telling? What he was telling?
In the suffering, we are my friends.
What is your comment?
When Indra killed Vishwarup, that means son of Tvastra Rishi. Vishwarup, mother dynasty was demon and father dynasty was demigods. So during fire sacrifice, he was doing swaha swaha, louder and louder for demigods. Sometime being silent, being low voice, he did saha for his mother dynasty. So Indra came to know this fact and told, oh, he's so silly, so tricker, cheater. He is doing swaha for his mother dynasty also. That means demon will be developed. So at once he came and killed Vishwarup, the Brahmin boy. So his father Tvastra became furious and he did one fire sacrifice. His inner mood that I want a son who can kill Indra. But she uttered the Vedic mantras. Indra
says some defect.
Indra Satra Vivardhasa. But there is some defect. Indra Satra Vivardhasa. That means who will kill by Indra, he will be get up from this higher sacrifice. He wants that killer of Indra must come from this fire sacrifice due to bad pronunciation and he traced some different word. So who will be killed by Indra? He came out from fire sacrifice. He was Dhritarashtra. In his first birth, first life, he was Chitraketu Maharaj.
After that, when he will be killed, then
he came from fire sacrifice and he challenged Indra. There is a great battle took place there. Indra tried to his best to kill that Dhritarashtra
with his
thunderbolt.
But he could not.
But he could not do so. He told, oh, you are insignificant. You could not kill me. My mind will remember you You are my master of life. Manasmare asupate drinita bhaktarma karotu kaya. By my speech.
Is sambodhan.
Oh Prana.
Oh my mind should always remember you.
My mind must remember you. And drinita bhaktarma karotu kaya. By speech, I shall glorify you. And by body, I shall serve you. Then some God became
Nana Kapristam Nacha
satisfied, then he again prayed. Nana Kapristam Napa Nachapada Mistam Nasarva Homam Narasadipatam Najoga Siddhi Rapunar Bhavamba Samanja Sattva Virahacha Kanche Nana Kapristam. That is telling you can take heavenly planet, kingdom of heavenly planet. No, Prabhu, I don't want. You want more? Nanaka Krishna Machasara Homam.
Why he did not want this Nanaka?
Because Nanaka Krishna, if someone go to heavenly planet, he had to come again this material world. Because Chine Punne Martalokam Visanti. When our past activity will be finished, we have to come again this material world in the chain of birth and death. So you don't want. Nasara Homam. Emperor of this material world. No, I don't want. Why not? Because material world is full of suffering and sorrows and distress. So I don't want. Rasadipattam, kingdom of Patal Lok. There is
like Bali Maharaj.
Like Bali Maharaj. There is more opulence than this material world. There is 14 loks in this planet. Bhuva, Maha, Jana, Tapa, Satta. Gradually, more and more opulence from Bhulok to Bhuvalok, from Bhuvalok to Sattalok, gradually after Sattalok. And in down low, Atal, Vital, Sutal, Talatal, Mahatal, Rasatal, Patal. Gradually also more and opulence downstairs, down locus. Bali Maharaja Sutalok. After that, Mahatal, Sadabat, three loks, more and down. So, you know, no Rasadipattam, I don't want. Because that also always suffering and sorrows, they will call each other. There is no sadhan bhajan. So I don't want to go there also being a master of Rasadipattam, Patallo. Na yoga siddhi. Then you can take yoga siddhi, anima, lagima, mahima, anything. Well, I don't want. It is also not for permanent happiness. Only some temporary happiness, only for sukh, not ananda there. Apunar bhavamma, to mukti lelo apunar bhavamma, no apunar bhavam, if there is no birth. Apunar bhavam means again birth and birth again and again. Apunar bhavam, no birth. That means mukti. You can tell mukti, no Prabhu, I don't want. Because it is Bhagavatam, Diyamanam apina grinnanti vinamat sevanam jana. If God wants to do salvation for any devotee, then Prabhu, you don't want. So, Dhritarashtra also telling, no, I don't want this apunar bhavam. You are qualified to give anything, I don't want. I want only virahajya kanche. I want to kill your separation. Then how, when they will come, then I will serve you eternally.
I want to serve only. Except this, I don't want to accept anything that
except your service, I don't want anything, which I told us before.
Yeah, virahaya means giving, accept this.
That's then he's again praying, ajata pakchaiva mataram khaga stannam jatha vaksatara chudartha priyam priyiva kusitam kusanda manura vinda saddi sadetam ajata pakchaiva mataram khaga. Oh God, I want to pray like a wingless bird. When a baby bird, the mother can keep them in nest when for their food supply. The Vajata Paksha, the baby bird always remember for his mother. When mother will come feed me and I will be free from fear. Then maybe vulture come and I will come take me back. When mother will come, she will protect me. She always remembers mother, as mother. Because sister, I don't like to pray like baby boy. Then, then, like a cow, he always praying for his mother. Mother went for grazing. When milkman will bring his mother, he is waiting for his mother always, mooing for his mother. As soon as he saw his mother, he began to laugh. He want to jump and want to go to his mother. Milkman want to untie this rope and want to creep from rope. What is so busy, want to go to mother immediate. And which way he want? He want to go for mother satisfaction? No, for his own satisfaction. And want to go honor of mother, not anywhere else. So here, the calf is superior to baby bird. Because bird bring any insect from outside, not from his body. And here, calf is taking milk from his mother, order is connected with her body. So it is more superior to baby bird. Then he is not satisfied yet. At first only is remembering for mother, only remember. Here, Kirtan and remembers more and both. He is remembering his mother and knowing for his mother, that's like Kirtan. So, at last he is telling, Priyam Priyeva Bhusitam Bhusanna Manora Vrinda Sadhidik Satetam. Although I don't want to pray like this also. So what you like? Priyam Priyeva Bhusitam Bhusanna. If there is a lover and beloved, if lover and parent are beloved, then he came, only telegram came or phone call came, I am coming. Then she is always so worried, when he will come, always remembering. And he is glorifying his beloved, his lover, among his children, among his friends. Oh, he is so qualified, he has so many virtues. Like this, he is always telling. He is remembering and doing kirtan and glorifying when he will come. And when he will come, he don't want for his own happiness. She wants to serve him and want to satisfy him. So, in symptom of Srimad Bhagavatam, Vitrasura Badhavetam, one symptom of Srimad Bhagavatam must be there, Vitrasura Upakhan. So, in this sloka, at first, for baby bird, is remembering only and he wants his own satisfaction, not his mother's satisfaction. And second, the calf, he also wants his own satisfaction, but connected with his mother. And third, a Shravan Kirtan Smaran, three are here. And she don't want his own satisfaction, she wants to satisfy him, his lover. He had not mentioned husband and wife, poti and stri, but priyam is priyeva. There is more lovely connection between priya and priya. In husband and wife, their relation is some narrow, some not so broad. But here, relation between priya and priya is so high. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, in Paramarmu, the gopis loves Krishna as their priya among priya and priya. So in this focus, it hints the mood of gopis, Paramarmu, gopis towards Krishna. After that is again praying. Mamottama sloka janesu.
Thank you. Have you clearly understood? Govind Bhagat, tell what he told in very brief.
So, in the leadership of the group, was explaining the prayer by Vijasura. He explained the prayer by Vijasura. There are three different relationships which were explained. The first is the baby bird, which...
Why only three? Three examples. Why? Why three? Why three? Because he has promised three things. For Manashmari. Agnit Vata Karma Karotu Kaya. We have only three things: body, mind and tongue to do. So he has prayed to God, Supreme Personality of Godhead, that I want to pray you that my mind should be always engaged in meditating first. Then, grinita vaka. Always my tongue should be engaged in chanting name, glorifying Krishna, telling pastimes of Krishna. And karma karotu kayava. That my body should always be engaged in serving me. Three things. For three things is giving example. My mind should always meditating like a baby bird who has no wings. His mother, their mothers have gone to pick up, collect some green or anything for them. Now the boys, children, those who have no wings at all, they are meditating his mother. Oh, when mother will come? When mother always waiting very eagerly. By two reasons. If their mothers will come, then they will have something to eat. And without this, they will die. And secondly, they are so fearing from other crows and other birds, owls. If our mother is absent there, they will at once take and take. So it's also fear. So they are always meditating with her mother. When mother will come, when mother will come, waiting eager. But they cannot at all. So I want always meditate you in your mind. But telling this, he began to think there are something lacking in this. Only selfishness is there. Only to take something and to remove his fears. Oh, should I do in the same way to Krishna? No, I don't. But I should remember just as baby birds, always. Oh, where mother? When Krishna come? I, again, we should try. Always, eagerly waiting for Krishna. Vita utakantha. Then, but he saw that there are some defects. I should not be like that birds. But only one thing. Always eagerly, eager is there. I should take it. Not other thing, selfishness. Then he told second thing. But second thing?
Baksha
tarachudhata. Cows cough. When mother goes to graze in fields here and there, whole day, he is waiting. But when some darkness becomes to come and evening coming, his eagerness so hard, then he begins to do da-da, like mowing. Very eagerly and mowing also. So mowing is like kirtan. Smaranam was first like meditation. like baby, that child. And this is like calf. That is doing also. Oh, and mother, oh mother, come on, come on. And here he wants to call Krishna. Oh Krishna, hey Nath, Ramana, Prashta, Kwashi, Kwashi Mahapuja, Kripanaya, Dasyaste, Kripanaya, Sakhe,
Sannidhi.
Oh Krishna, oh Nath, oh Nath, you should come at once. I will die if you are not coming. So Kirtan is like that. And also meditating like that. But he also reminded himself that, oh, there is some loop and hole. I want to cry like that to Govatsa, God. But not his selfishness. He only crying for milk. Only. The birds will take anything and give to their childs outside of their body. But cows will give milk from his own ear and supporting these cows. So, calf is only crying and meditating for his selfness. That mother will come and share milk, giving her milk. So he rejected these examples also. He took only two things from them. From only meditate from that. And cows buck off two. Crying and meditating both. And thirdly, he took the example of any beloved. If any beloved is very far away, then a chaste wife always meditating, when he will come, when he will come. And sometimes he glorifies. Oh, why he comes? I know that he has so much love and affection for me. He knows that I cannot leave. He is so merciful. He supports me. So, also, Kirtan also, meditating also, and one thing that there is nowhere in two examples. What was that?
What is
selfless, selfless love and affection. So he wanted like this. Like when he will come to home, his wife will give sweet butter, delicious food, and very affectionate, loving, talking something. Like mother also. Like servant and moreover like beloved. So here he is telling, like this. So this is a sentence like Gopi Samba. So this Chitraketu Maharaj, that this prayer is more higher than Prahlad. Even other paths are so there, so important. Now he is telling. So he lastly he is praying. Mamattama slok janesu sakyam. I am not sparking fire to do these three things. I cannot meditate like that. Baby bird, selfish, not like calf. I do kirtan, I cannot do kirtan like him and meditate. Oh. Not like a chaste lady or beloved lady. Three things doing, chanting, waiting eagerly. Nainam galadashu dharaya padanam gadagadam dhyayam. Kulikar netitam babur padar padanam dhyayam. Oh, I can't do it. Because I have no love and affection. So, he is telling them, oh, I am unqualified for all this. Well, he wants, very simple, mamattam shloka janesu shakyam sansara chakre pramateshvakara. By my sinful activities and good activities, if I am taking birth and again day, this chain of birth repeatedly, a cycle, of birth and death. And in that I am suffering from so many things, so many rogues, so many problems, but yet I pray you that I should have a birth near to any devotee, and I have a friendship, I should have a friendship to that devotee. Tanmaya to atmaja dargeheshu asakta chittasya na nath medhya. O Nath, you are what if I have to give anything, you have power to give anything. But I want simply this thing, that in this world, if my birth is there, then I have some friendship with any pure devotee. O Nath, O Lord, I want that you should have a benediction that your maya, illusory maya is so powerful, so covered by this, controlled by this maya, I should not be attached to my family, my children, my wife, my
house
or opulence, anything, very beautiful gardens, dogs, cows or anything. You should take my this thing and I should have friendship, always association of that devotee I want. By these three things will raise you. And seeing there, Krishna did so much mercy to Krishna. And this was regarded by Chitraketu himself in his past life. And Chitraketu, anyhow, he had the association of Narada and Parvata Rishi. And by that, he left his home, his so much attraction for his one son of 5 years, and he took to death. He was given poison and he was dead. And he was crying bitterly with his whole family. Narada and they came and they pacified him. And they advised that you should do bhajan, do shankarsan. And they began to do quickly their liberated from this. So, we should try to be like that. Our today class is now. करता है ना मन के द्वारा स्मरण जीवा के द्वारा उनका गुण कीर्तन और बड़ी के द्वारा सेवा.
Yeah.
Gaur Prema.
Ready?
So he is telling also these teachings to them, and if they are following, then they will come to the light. Otherwise, no.
Where is the stuff in the face?
And secondly,
Narayan,
those who do the
alright, so you don't have to touch the cord, you don't
Oh, for man,
All glory to Advaita Chandra, and all glories to the devotees of Lord Gauranga. Once upon a time, at the residence of Hiranya and Govardhan, discourses took place by which the glories of Haridas Thakur became apparent to all. All devotees, please listen to that wonderful story.
They are not the true benefit of chanting the name. By actually chanting Hare Krishna without offense, one awakens his ecstatic love for Krishna. If one is actually advanced and takes pleasure in chanting the holy name of the Lord, he becomes agitated. Sometimes he chants like a madman, laughter and weeping, fully experiencing the ecstasy of love. Liberation, the extinction of sinful reactions, are simply a mere insignificant drop compared to the benefit that comes from chanting. All glories to the chanting of the holy name, which removes the burden of the entire world. Ajamya. He chanted the holy name of the Lord, calling his son Narayan, but still he attained his spiritual kingdom. What to speak of the benefit for one who chants with faith and veneration?
Oh, assembly of learned scholars, just hear the ramblings of this sentimental Vaishnava. After millions and millions of births, and then understanding all of the absolute knowledge, it still may not be possible to attain liberation. Yet he thinks that simply by a glimpse of Krishna's names, one may attain this highly advanced position.
You're a fool, Arjas.
Why do not? In all the revealed scriptures, it is described that one achieves liberation by nowadays. Those devotees who are immersed in the ocean of transcendental bliss, any other happiness is insignificant, including Brahmanda. It is like a little bit of water contained in the footprint of your path.
Arjas, if one cannot attain liberation by Namabhas, then I will certainly cut off your nose.
If one cannot attain liberation by Namabhas, I will cut off my own.
So, Paul Chakrabarty, you have insulted Arjas. Nothing good can come from this. It's all under suspiciousness.
Prabhu Chakrabarty, you are not welcome. Get out!
You have done no harm. No fault. And there's no fault for this foolish Brahmin, so-called Brahmin. He is addicted to mental speculation. One cannot understand the glories of the holy name by logic. But by chanting the holy name, one will realize everything. Go back to your homes. May Lord Krishna bless all of you. Always chant the holy name of Krishna. And please do not consider that any offense can be done. Hare Krishna.
All the members of the assembly who had heard the challenge were greatly agitated. Hiranya Govardhan boldly chastised Brahmin for his collective. These Palaramacharya chastised Gopal Chakrabarty. And when Haridas had to leave, all the members of the assembly fell at his lotus feet. He consoled them, saying that this is none of your fault. From the statement by Haridas, it is understood that a pure Vaishnava never takes anyone's insults seriously. This teaching of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srinadavi Sunichena, Karoji Sushusuna, Amanya Marayana, Kidanaksadavati. One should chant the holy name of the Lord in a humble state of mind, thinking oneself lower and destroying the street. One should be more tolerant than the tree, void of all sense of false prestige, and ready to offer all respects to others. In such a state of mind, one can chant the holy name of the Lord constantly. A Vaishnava is always tolerant and submissive like trees and grass. He tolerates insults offered by others, for he is simply interested in chanting the holy name of the Lord without being disturbed. Within 3 days, that Brahmin was attacked by leprosy, and as a result of his highly raised nose, melted away and fell off. The Brahmin's toes and fingers were beautiful like golden colored champaka buds, but because of leprosy, they all withered and gradually melted away. Seeing the condition of Gopal Charakvati, everyone was astonished. Haridas Thakur was not at all happy or pleased to see him in such a suffering condition. But everyone, seeing the influence of Haridas Thakur, offered him obeisances. Although Haridas Thakur was a Vaishnava, he did not take seriously the Brahmin's offense. But the Supreme Personality of Godhead could not tolerate it, and thus he made the Brahmin suffer the consequences. A characteristic of a pure devotee is that he excuses any offense by an ignorant rascal. The characteristic of Krishna, however, is that he cannot tolerate blasphemy of his devotees. So, my dear devotees, in the path of devotional service, please be aware of the mad elephant offense and never, never, never offend your devotee. Hare Krishna.